What's the difference between lead and lead-free alloys for soldering and repairing printed circuit boards? It's not just about which is harmful and which is safe, although that also matters. In this video, I will explain the practical use of different soldering alloys in manufacturing, repairing, and home soldering. What is lead soldering alloy? It's the classic choice, the most common alloy, tin-63 and lead or plumbum 37, with melting temperature 183 degrees of the Celsius. It's amazing for soldering and repair all electronics where reliability is important. Aviation, military equipment, railway technology and medical devices are almost always soldered with lead alloys, unless there are special requirements. Why? Because excellent wetting. Lead alloys can flow into the smallest holes in PCB with soldering flux, of course. Lead alloy creates a strong joint if you properly preheat all surfaces. Video about soldering temperature in description. High mechanical and vibration resistance because the lead alloy is more elastic. It withstands vibration test and thermal shocks. Sharp temperature change from minus 40 to plus 80 degrees of the Celsius. Mass PCBs experience dynamic loss during use, drops, shocks and shaking. Due to its elasticity, lead soldering joints are less prone to self-destructions and cracking, of course assuming the production technologies is followed. Lead alloy forgives mistakes better. If you overheat it during soldering, it usually does not have a major impact. Still, avoid overheating, will be poor quality. Comment what solder alloy you use and subscribe to the channel while you are here. Now about lead-free alloys. After 2006, thanks to RoHS directive, the mass market switched to lead-free alloys. The most common are SAC-305, tin-96.5%, silver-3% and copper-0.5% or similar lead-free composition. Higher melting temperature, 217-221 degrees of the Celsius. The higher soldering temperature puts more and unnecessary thermal stress on components. Yes, modern electronic components can briefly tolerate such temperatures, but it's still thermal shock. Lead-free alloys have much worse elasticity and flowability than traditional lead solder alloys. PCBs using lead-free solders are more fragile and fail more often due to microcracks in lead-free joints. They also handle vibrations worse. You must properly set the cooling profile when using lead-free alloys. It directly affects the brittleness and reliability of solder joints. Link to the video about soldering profiles in description. Lead-free solder alloy perform worse under thermal cycling. That's why video cards using lead-free solder alloy often require cheap replacements or BGA reballing due to overheating. Their upsides. Higher melting temperatures allow lead-free alloys to withstand higher temperatures during operation without suffering melt damage. They also don't contain lead, which accumulates on the planet as waste from old PCBs. Did you know that NASA doesn't use lead-free alloys? Also, Canadian customs often reject PCBs soldered with lead alloys. Share your thoughts in the comments. Next topic. Can we soldering one PCB with lead and lead-free alloys? In manufacturing, no. It's inconvenient to soldering PCB with different types of soldering alloys. This makes no sense and violates quality control. But in repair, yes, if you know what you're doing. If the PCB was originally soldered with lead alloy, then it's better to use a lead alloy for repair. But if you are replacing a lead-free BGA chip or lead PCB, then when heating with hot air, the lead alloy on the PCB will melt before lead-free solder balls on the BGA chip. It's okay. The main thing is to make sure that there are no heavy components on the bottom of the PCB that can fall when the solder melts. The opposite situation when soldering lead BGA chip on lead-free PCB. In this case, the lead alloy at the BGA chip will melt first and easily soldering to contact parts of the PCB. Next topic, what about low-temperature bismuth alloys? The use of solder alloys containing bismuth for soldering PCB is not recommended. These alloys are very unreliable and sensitive to heat during future work of electronics. Bismuth solder is unreliable under vibration, mechanical stress and thermal shock. Using bismuth in printed circuit boards is a serious mistake, don't use it. Bismuth alloys can be useful when desoldering components. Adding bismuth alloy can lower the melting point of lead-free joints, making it easy to remove components. After desoldering, be sure to clean the pads with copper braid. I have never used bismuth alloy for desoldering. I do fine with bottom preheating station and hot air. Do you use bismuth alloy in your practice? Share in the comments. Next topic. What alloys do manufacturers use? In manufacturing, consistency and predictability are crucial. In practice, it doesn't matter which alloys is used. It is more important that the soldering processes and profiles are set up correctly. For manual soldering with lead-free alloys, higher quality soldering iron tips and professional soldering station are needed to avoid early iron tip degradation due to high temperatures. Let me know in the comments which alloys you use when soldering and repair electronics. Lead, lead-free or bismuth, which do you find easier to work with? Which one cracks more often in your experience? Like this video and other engineers can find this video too. Share this video in your social media, please. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. I have a lot of useful information. In description on this video, you can find links to my Instagram, my Telegram group, to my Patreon if you want to support my YouTube channel, also to my website with soldering fluxes, consulting and PCB repair services for electronics manufacturers. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.